You guys had questions, and I've got some answers. It is time for another Astro Stuff, Astro Stuff, Astro Stuff. Okay, let's get this show on the road. O-Dog the Invincible asks, what are the odds that someone has existed before that had my exact genetic code? Do I have a medieval or Roman twin? Well, even identical twins or clones aren't completely genetically identical. Even though they might start that way, through development they might get 300 to 400 or even more genetic mutations. And a lot of the difference that we see even in identical twins is due to gene expression and not the actual gene mutations. But consider this. Each parent gives 23 chromosomes to either its sperm or its egg. That means there's 8.4 million different combinations that those can shuffle up. Combine two parents and you've got a 1 in 70 trillion chance, and that's without any of that genetic crossover that goes on in meiosis. So I guess while nothing in the universe is completely impossible, this is probably about as close as it gets. Bazingors sent in a question by Instagram. How likely is a zombie apocalypse? Not very likely, considering that zombies are not real. But that doesn't stop people from researching it. Epidemiologists actually use zombie films as a way to predict disease outbreaks. And it turns out that film directors have figured out exactly when to bring in that big army to kill all the zombies in order to save humanity. And it lines up pretty well with what we see in actual diseases. There's a pretty good article about that that I'm gonna put down in the description. Festworks asks, please explain why a piece of bread will soften up hardened Christmas cookies. Contrary to popular belief, things don't get stale because they lose water. It's actually the starch granules inside that bread or those cookies crystallizing from its gelatinous form. Christmas cookies are full of sugar, and sugar is what we call hygroscopic, which means that it wants to hold on to water and it sucks it out of the atmosphere. So if you put a moist piece of white bread in there, it actually sucks up the water from that bread and gets them all soft again. Martin Chan asks, why does cheese smell like feet? Martin, are you sure you want to know the answer to this question? Because you can't unknow what I'm about to tell you. Cheese smells like feet because feet smell like cheese because, well, they have a lot of the same bacteria. In fact, there's one species called Brevibacterium that makes this compound called methanethiol, and it's found both between your toes and in a lot of pungent cheeses. There's actually a study done at Brown University where when people were blindfolded, they couldn't tell the difference between Parmesan and vomit. Man, we should do a whole episode on cheese. Hey guys, let's do a whole episode on cheese. At Alexa Whitaker asks, how did you initially fall in love with the field of biology? I don't really remember the exact moment because I can barely remember what I had for breakfast. Physics gets all the love, and I know it's really cool to understand like the workings of the universe and basic matter, but biology is the study of a conscious being understanding itself. Intricate chemical machinery that evolves and changes over time, all due to inanimate forces of natural selection. It completely blows my mind. One thing I will tell you, I remember the first time that I saw a cell under the microscope, and since that day, the more I've learned, I'm amazed that anything works at all. That's why I love biology. Sink Her Ship asked, do you have a favorite scientist? Man, picking a favorite scientist is like asking which one of your children you love the best, but if I had to pick one, definitely Richard Feynman. He was the best explainer ever. He was funny, he was charming. He could tell the best stories. Oh, and I gotta have a little bit orange juice. I gotta have a little bit orange juice. He won a Nobel Prize. I mean, he's a brilliant guy. I'll tell you what, I'm just gonna put a link to a series that he did called Fun to Imagine down in the description. Watch that, and I promise you will fall in love with him too. Thank you to everybody who sent in questions for this Ask Joe. Remember, you can always ask me questions at itsokaytobesmart.com. Email address and the Twitter handle are down below. And subscribe by clicking on my head, I guess. And you can learn new fun science facts every week. Thanks a lot, and stay curious. Fruits are plants' way of tricking animals into eating their seeds. So while we'll throw this away, for animals, everything goes in, and then later, everything comes out.